to Mitch. I say a little bit, actually a lot. Mitch is very low on HP for Cloud9. There's the paranoia towards U-Hauls. They're going to be working their way in. Watch out for the nano swarm. Oh. The flash comes out on top of Zek. Zek barely gets away, and the shots deliver a final killing blow to Nismo. Around the corner goes the Frenzy. Would have expected to see a little bit more there, but Dazzle with a quick response on Deleve. The site has not really been controlled as of yet. They're trying to get the spike planted, but it's awkward to say the least. The fight's not really working out well as they peek out yet again. Sunny able to get another kill on the round. 13-9 on this map, Bind to Ghost to E-United, ultimately winning Haven 13-6. So it was actually a pretty strong victory going into that third map. I'm sure you're saying it's a three-map series, but the wins being 13-6, 13-5, that's not too shabby for Ghost. Now, unfortunately, like I said, one map that they did struggle on was Bind. Not exactly ideal. Mass TP coming out, but Mitch! Mitch was holding the...
Really a pistol to work with? Oh, good flashpoint to come out. That sets up Vice beautifully. Excellent support there from Sunny. Nismo's holding for any kind of teleport at this point in time, but C9 just took the right amount of aggression and were able to succeed because of it.
Mitch spraying away through the smoke, looking to do some additional damage, but hasn't as of yet really connected with much as they start to back off and escape from Hookah. And the buy is not exactly what you'd want to see for Ghost. It's a force up. They're trying to make do with frenzies and stingers, of course. Now Sunny does get tagged on the attempted beat. There's the fault line coming out. Neither player was hit. So with a misunderstanding there from Sunny, who goes for the wide swing on that. Now Chase is on site trying to span through, has to be careful. There's one elbow, that's Vice picking it up from distance. And now it's down to just one. Nismo with the SMG at least making the round count a little bit more, doing a little bit more damage. But again, three players in front and the ult of Sova is just taking your time. Whereas it feels like he wants to just go one, two, three, like fire him off real quick.
Oh, Mitch. Little bit of overkill. The headshot operator. Oh man, feels like Ghost, they had that round in their grasp. And that's a huge missed opportunity. We'll see if they're able to recover the situation though. 3v4, and they have a couple of ultimates. The Showstopper is in play for Nismo. I feel like this is as good of an opportunity as any. The rotation has already come in from Leaf. There are three players here at B as Relix is already on the flank. He's pushed out Showers. He's there toward short A. They should have all the information in the world, but they may not have their lives. Chase takes down Vice. Maybe they can get something else. Leaf's there to recover the situation. The Showstopper's out, and Nismo's able to pick up two massive kills. And now it's just onto Relix. The paranoia comes out. He forces them off of the angle, and this positioning actually... Can Relix break the situation down is the question. Oh, I don't know if that CP is exactly where he wanted it to go, because it was right in the middle of the window. But both players now pushing into the smoke, as a matter of fact. And Relix, he's still unsure of where they both are. Oh, there's one! And Payne takes him down.
Again, you're going to see a lot of players grouped up in Hookah. Relix with the port has to worry about Run It Pack, which has been utilized by Chase. That shut down pretty quickly as they try to fly into the site. You've got Dazzle already up into position, but so is Nismo, who snuck onto site. Now Relix is inside Tuna Can, turns things back around. They have to be careful because there's concern over what could be coming this direction. As the ult comes through, but is ultimately canceled, the Defender Killjoy is going to catch them off guard and force them away from the site. So good Killjoy ult coming out from Leaf, but it's up to Leaf and Leaf alone. He's had some impressive shots thus far. Quick one coming out onto Dazzle, but as the pair... And again, it's Sunny, also known as Zeta, playing from Korea with 200 ping. Has to be careful. The nade's going to do a lot of damage as he goes for the peek. Has to be careful. Now the flash is right on the money. That allows them to get in on the back end of this play. Nice aftershock as well to force Payne into a corner. Vice is chiming in. Things are stacking up nicely for Cloud9. You find yourselves in this position, but Ghost, they're lucky that they have the firepower.
Regardless. All right, they're reconsidering their options, and they're splitting up. They will be met by Mitch. He pulls out the knives, and right then and there, actually, player turns away, but Chase is there to recover. And now the man advantage is in favor of Ghost, but Sunny just pushes on forward. He's able to take down the run it back. Nizmo, he's stunned up. He has the Showstopper out. Is he able to find anything here? He will take down Sunny. But 4v3, advantage still lies with Ghost. And Vice still has great position towards Hookah. This round is all out of whack, and Vice is able to take down one. There goes Leak inside the tuna can, and then Vice is able to find the final two kills. C9 steal that one away from Ghost.
Well, why am I blanking on this agent? Oh my god, that's not a good sign. Getting too old. Boomer Brain can't handle it anymore. Regardless, Sunny was not typically a breach main, but Sunny! You know, we just talked about it, how the flash doesn't always work out so well for you because it's not self-servicing. There's the delay in pulling out your rifle, but it doesn't seem to impact Sunny at all here. As Sunny finds two on the round, it's now down to Nizmo on the edge of the smoke, spots Mitch. And now it's a 1v1. It's Nizmo versus Leaf, the star performer at times for Cloud9 against the lead man from Ghost. And as Nizmo rotates over, Leaf is already there, coming through spawn through the vents. And in the 1v1, Nizmo's just going to go for the peek, but Leaf wins the battle in the 1v1.
Close half.
So I went back and looked again. I just was brain farting in that round. Zeta played Omen, Sova, and Sky more recently for Cloud9 Korea. I don't know why I couldn't think. I just was feeling dumb. Whatever. Case may be. It doesn't matter as it's a pistol round live, and Pain is the only one left, as Pain is what Ghost is currently feeling. Not to be confused with the last player left standing, who's also feeling his own share of pain. Sitting at 52 HP, trying to scrape up some success here on the round. Now Relix has just dropped multiple smokes in his path. Pain going through it, not going to work out so well today. Follows the pistols, as we've seen them succumb to some force buys in the past. Mitch, leading the attack, dives right into the hot hands, and oh, that daze could have been perfect. That was from the fault line. There's a curveball coming in as they go for the peak. There's a counter flashpoint coming out from their breach. Now they're trapped around the corner. This is a little sketchy for the remaining members inside Hookah. Dazzle from distance, trying to at least slow them down. There's the recon dart going out. There is some backup on site from Zek, but hold on. Sunny with two? How? Sunny with the SMG, proving that he's not just a distraction. Doesn't matter in the end, as Payan lines things up. But man, that was way closer than maybe it should. Temporary stand-in, and you're playing with the trial. Are you really going to roll the dice on a map like potentially Icebox? Probably not. So it's an understandable position to find yourselves in if you're Cloud9 to try to stick to the vanilla maps that everyone's used to. The ones we've seen played time and time again. The take works out well for Cloud9 as they had a player or two-player advantage. As I said that, though, Zek picked off one underneath the Cloudburst that was laid out at his feet. Ultimately, does fall to Mitch, who's got a great round coming in as the jet main who has filled the shoes for tens. Mitch with a target right around the corner, but it looks like the remaining members of Ghost have decided to back off of the play. They'll surrender control of the scoreboard again. Cloud9 will take the lead, 9-8. As Ghost just couldn't seem to contain the push on the A site. But I'm buying in Haven. It's kind of awkward, and I don't really have enough to say how well it'll work on Icebox. We did see it play out earlier today in one of the early series of the day. Relix sneaking into the corner, waiting for them to try to come through from spawn. There's the rocket being pulled out, and there's the ult coming in as well. So they're trying to send some pulses downrange. Now, they could cancel out this ult, and they do. The lockdown is destroyed. As Ghost continues to try and go for the retake, Relix is going to scoot his way across with the Shrouded Step. Nice shock dart right on Mitch's feet. Even with the paranoia, nearsightedness not going to affect Mitch too much. Zek has to pick up the pieces. And unfortunately, Dazzle is stuck currently inside a dark cover that landed on Heaven, looking for a line on the edge. Does end up dinking Relix with a follow-up as well, but Leaf immediately shuts Dazzle down. Nizmo on a very long flank and has to be worried because there is a Sova currently watching that, but Nizmo is going to go the complete other direction around through the wishbone to try and come up either on the other side of Showers or Short. They are taking their time getting into this position. It's going to be a serious crunch on the site. Mitch has to step up big, and there's the kill on to Chase. Now, Nizmo does finally come through on that flank. Sunny drops Zek, and Nizmo is the only one that remains as Mitch from distance slides out another knife
Ken actually is going to keep his camera up to maybe enable this even further. Now, Dazzle, he's been struggling with the Hunter's Fury all day, but he's actually able to get a kill. 3v5 now. The spike will finally be planted. And there are a couple of ultimates here that Ghost can use, perhaps, that could help them out. Maybe not the Cypher, but the Run It Back is available. Oh, and there's the flash for Sunny, and the spray down is there! 4 kills for Sunny! Huge for them, shutting down that Ghost play. It just leaves Zek in the 1v2. He's got no HP to work with, and Sunny will pick up the ace. The
Jet who dashes across, that's Mitch. Zek has to get out of dodge. Relix goes for the ult to get into a better position. Somehow, Zek is still able to get the best of Mitch, despite the fact that his position was spotted out early. Relix from on high, taken down by Zek, who has to now keep his head on a swivel. There's a player behind him, has to go back through, but Vice quickly switches to the pistol. It was looking promising for Zek to maybe even find one more kill. Again, we mentioned it. A little bit of a rough start, but starting to warm up a bit. But now it's down to Payne. A 1v2, and that turret is going to be a hassle. He's going to spot out his position right here. Doesn't matter. At least he gets the kill onto Lee. Takes minimal damage. Oh. Payne! That's huge! Ghosts are still in this game. 12. We've seen this time and time again. Using Sunny's hardware more specifically as a fake, but they haven't bit. They not only take out Sunny, but they stick on the site. You've still got players here playing defense, but they're falling. And it's down to now just two. This should have been a lot easier for them. Now the Killjoy ult gets utilized. That's going to force the players who are still here out of sight. And there's only one that remains. It's Payne. Cloud9 end up closing things out.
Just super impressive. I think people are in for a treat here if they're unaware. Venismo is there to greet Mitch. Paranoia comes out. But look at just the layered utility right now for C9. They're putting so much pressure on Ghost. But okay, there's the Sage Wall actually coming out. That will, in fact, stop C9 in their tracks. But do they know that Vice is all the way on site and he's actually made it into spawn? Okay, somehow C9 just absolutely duped Ghosts.
So not only was Vice here, but they also had the spike out. Vice just has to go to the right click to do some additional damage. Now his second target was low, but they do take out Sage. The wall's about to drop and Relix is still behind it. The Boombot got slowed in that slow orb and went up on the wall, still detonated, did about 51 damage to Relix with a nice quick shot onto Payan. Relix bids adieu as he ends up getting traded out by Dazzle. It's all down to Dazzle now in the 1v3, and ultimately it will be Cloud9's round to take. Even a turret.
It looked like it was getting shut out, but they will go for mid take here. Relix with the Boombot out forward. It actually did so much damage there to Dazzle. Oh my god, the last shot there from Relix actually takes down Dazzle. That is so unfortunate if you're on the receiving end of that play. Now, it looks like it's going to be a pretty clean one for C9 here. Nismo will get a kill, but Leaf with the three piece takes him down and shoots onto the B and A. I think Gen.G was one of the first that put together a really good Sage exec, so we'll see if Ghosts have that here. But they are trying to put a defense together right here, right now. And they actually take down two players. Currently a player under Heaven in Relix. Now Vice is going to try to hold on to this position. Nanobots are out. There's three players towards screens. And Vice, he knows he has to try to fight his way out of the situation. Here comes the setup from Sunny, but it doesn't actually accomplish much of anything. And Sunny is a very labored spray, but he's able to get one. But there's only 5 bullets left in the chamber. And Zek just peeks him. And there's not a lot Sunny can do. When he has 200 ping, it's just so difficult to hold those angles.
Ghost, pick up a must-win round much sooner than on B. And it's up to Ghost to try and retake, and the hardware is not what you want.
No, definitely not. At this point, Ghost, a couple kills would be great. One enemy remaining. But Vice is putting an end to that. Nice kills from him on the lurk. You know, we've mentioned him before, Vice, in-game leader of this team right now, just rarely comes up with the big games, but always that consistent player, and it's his role on these rounds that usually just isn't rewarding.
5v5 retake with Rolling Thunder and the Showstopper still available. There's the Showstopper being pulled from Relix. The rocket's right where it needs to be, but no! It goes around the corner, that's a problem. Mitch, missing the knives as well, has to switch back to the rifle. The Rolling Thunder isn't where it needs to be. All of this utility utilized. But it's not doing much. It's Leaf now in a 1v3. after picking up the first kill that made it a 1v3 in the first place, gets a second as well, but finally taken out by Zek.
So I guess this could be a solution too, but it's more so a gimmick given that they are on a pretty poor buy, but the utility is ready. And they might actually have a timing here. Dazzle is right around the corner, but he meets Mitch on the other end of his scope, and Mitch just gets two right there. They've already dealt with one side of this two-pronged attack, and Leaf, he's only able to get one. I'm a little bit surprised, but Mitch, I mean, he'll just keep on going. That's what he does on this map. Well, it's usually what he keeps on doing, but Payne actually takes him down. Yeah, it happens. But yeah, I think that's just the biggest weak point we've seen.
Currently in Mailroom, they're about ready to explode into B Heaven. It's just a matter of time. Chase is waiting around the corner. That's a missed shot coming in from Mitch, who went to the sidearm given the close distance. Leaf immediately takes out Chase, but that's a big piece for them to be missing out on. Vice, the turret spots one inside the site. They've got 30 seconds left to make a move. Nismo pops the ult, doesn't even get a chance to fire. That's disappointing. Leaf from distance up off the top rope. And just like that, Cloud9 gains site control over on B. You've got Leaf sitting on top of double stack, holding, waiting for the peek to come through from the first player, knowing there's one here, not ready for Dazzle, who swings out wide and is paying this time with a response. 3K for 3K, the two teams trade, but it's...
This one the way you're supposed to, off their crossfires, putting so much pressure on anybody. Leaf, it looks like he wants to get antsy here, and there will be a flashpoint to enable him. Paranoia comes out, the trades are there in favor of actually Ghost. 2v3, and actually Payne takes down Relics. It's just down to Vice all of a sudden, and then paint shells come in. Nismo takes him down. Good retake from Ghost.
Ghost, they scrape together Cloud9. We'll see how this ends up working out. Nice dink shot from distance, actually, from Dazzle. He'll put Relics very low on HP. 38 health remains. Nice flashes coming out. That allows the peek from Mitch, but there's just too many players around the corner. The nade does go in to try and slow them down. But now it's time for the push. We'll see what they can do to try and stop this one. Nice pistol work coming out thus far from Sunny and Relics. And there's Vice with the shotgun as well. It's Zek alone on the site. Again, they wandered into a trap on this A site. Ghost caught off.
So it looks like it will be, in fact, a B play here coming out. Leaf is playing close right beside that turret. He's not able to get anything done. Chase with the instant headshot will take him down, but Vice is still playing around the site right now. There's so much pressure on Vice. He's able to actually get another. I can't believe that. Takes down Nismo as Nismo hits him from the grave. But here we go. Relics bust out the showstopper. That'll at least deny the plant. And he actually pushes on forward even more. Takes down Pan. It's hard to keep up with just how much Relics is doing in terms of putting this pressure on them. Zek with just 12 HP. What will him and Chase decide to do?
One back site. That's Chase. Goes for the peek towards main. Mitch is waiting. Zek opts to push through, but there's one currently holding that line. It's Relics, and he's going to be walking right into it. Relics is just too prevented momentarily.
Yeah, it should be a sixth round for Ghost here, unless Spike Leaf planted. And Relics can come up with something just purely magical is the only way I could put it. And okay, well, it starts with something like this. Dazzle's just got his back to Leaf, and
all right.
There we go. Leaf finds his third on the round. They're going to be keyed in on Leaf's angle, so this is really up to Relics to try to activate him at this point. And he's trying to fight both of these angles at once. It's so difficult right now, and they know that. But Leaf is actually going to keep on pushing forward. Takes down Pan. He is actually going to find five on the round in taking down Chase. There's just one player remaining in Nismo. He's on the site, and this... Oh, the showstopper comes out, and that should be it. Okay, a very close round out of Mitch. Gosh, this is so disciplined. The patience from these players right now. Yeah, just there's so much anticipation right now. Payne, though, he is going to push into the angle, and Mitch is rewarded because of it. And now Ghost, they have to weigh their options. They lost their A lurker, and it looks like they will be making their way up mail. But that is where three players from C9 are waiting.
Oh, they've got such a good setup for this, too. Look at the utility that's down in that area. There's nano swarms and alarm bots. They do take out the alarm bot. There's the nano swarm going down. A nade in response as well. The flash comes out. Sunny is trying to slow them down with that breach utility. The kit works out masterfully for them as it all falls onto Zek. Despite the spray down kill on Sunny at a distance, few players currently playing. You've got breach on site. You've got Ray's currently sitting back windows. That's Relics with a quick shot coming out from the op. The ult's been popped. The fuse is pulled, but it's not going to connect on this player right around the corner. And that leaves him in a terrible position. But Sonny's going big inside the site. Found two, somehow stayed alive to turn around and lay down a fault line. With just 8 seconds left, they do manage to get that spike secured. Dazzle's ult gets canceled, so they do want to fly in as fast as they possibly can. Cloud9, they win round number 13. Map number two will be theirs. Ghost has been eliminated, and the boys from C9 Blue will be moving on to the playoffs tomorrow.